I think the technology and the development of downhill bikes and bikes in general has been absolutely incredible, especially over the years of my career. How things have progressed and where we're at now with carbon downhill bikes that are pretty damn light, suspension that's amazing. I find it hard to really think about where they are going to go next with technology and with development. I don't think that bikes can become much lighter, especially downhill bikes, than we now have. I think the suspension's an area that constantly every year gets better and better, and I'm amazed every year that they come out with new ideas and new things to make the bikes seem even more amazing over rough ground. So that's an area that I think will always develop. The whole gearbox bike thing in downhill bikes is still really yet to be developed. A few companies have tried. I think that's still an area that for downhill that could be developed and could be something that could be an advantage for downhill racing. The brakes is another thing that I think every year, again, they're developing that, but I don't think much can change in small ways. I personally think that we've kind of got to a place where downhill bikes aren't going to see much difference over the next few years. The only thing I can think can happen is wheel size, and the big thing now that's happening mountain biking is the introduction of 29er wheels, and that's definitely taken over with cross country. And whether we see in the next 2 or 3 years' time more and more 29er enduro bikes and potentially 29er downhill bikes, and the advantages that that can give, I think we're still yet to explore. So that's kind of an area I can think there'll be some development in the next few years. I think the weight of the downhill bike is almost at a place where I think if they go much lighter, I think the bike would be quite unstable at high speed, and it's not necessarily the most important thing. I think for downhill, a little bit of weight sometimes is good for carrying speed. And I think one thing with the carbon bike, for me, I noticed the acceleration out of corners was definitely a big advantage over the aluminium bike, and just the general kind of carrying speed over the trail. I think if you're pretty fit and strong, you can also afford to run your bike a little harder in the setup of the suspension than most people. If you're fit and you're strong, you can basically hit the bumps a lot harder and stay on top of the bumps and carry speed rather than getting stuck in the holes in between and losing speed all the time. So if you can, I think you can gain a lot of time out of a fairly stiff setup and a bike that carries good speed. Okay, my bet for the World Cup winners in 2012. And I'll take a cut if I get this right and someone wins money on the dirt the dirt challenge, but I think the men's, it'll be Aaron Gwynn again. I think he's still young, he's still learning, and he's still so hungry to win. I think there's still a lot more to come from him, and I think he's now tasted what it's like to be successful, and there's no reason why he can't do that again. And I think on the women's, I think it was a year where Florian Pujan was pretty much constantly second all last year. Another year of experience from her and a new teammate with Brendan, I think will be a great combination for her to improve her riding, and she's definitely kind of the next generation coming through, and I think she'll be a good force to carry on her consistency in 2012. I think in 2011 my success came down to two things really. One was winning the World Championships in 2010. I fulfilled a massive goal in my career, so I was having fun on my bike, I had no pressure, and I also was maybe the fittest I've ever been entering the season. So a combination of fitness and fun, that's my secret for 2011, I think. I think the success of Trek World Racing last year was not only obviously down to myself and Aaron having a great year, but I also think the culmination of 3 or 4 years of really hard work from the Trek design team, from the first session in 88 I rode in 2009 to the Carbon 9.9 that we raced all last year, was a pretty amazing kind of transition from the bike that we started on. And I think a lot of success is down to they made a fantastic bike. The suspension platform that they worked on with Fox was incredible. The addition of the carbon bike gave us one of the lightest race bikes on the circuit. So I think having great equipment and also a great team and the knowledge that you're riding one of the best and the fastest bikes out there gives you the confidence to get success, which builds on success. So I think that's why the year went so well. Hola, 203mm.com. Hello, 203.203mm.com.